Good evening. I would like to welcome you to the March 12th, 2019 Guilford County School Board meeting. If we could stand, and Ms. McGregor, if you could lead us in the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the United States of America, and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Please remain standing for a moment of silence. Thank you.
Good evening. We will begin our meeting by recognizing the March Employee of the Month. Will Virginia Griffin please come forward to the podium? No one can doubt Virginia Griffin's dedication to Guilford County Schools. The Dudley High alumni retired from Guilford County Schools in 1994 with 30 years of teaching experience, but she couldn't stay away. She returned to Guilford County Schools in 1996 as a part-time teacher and currently teaches Spanish at Dudley High. This month, after serving more than 50 years in the district, she was named the March Guilford County School Employee of the Month. Virginia was nominated by Penn Griffin School for the Arts, Assistant Principal Charnell Shepherd, a former Dudley High teacher who considers Griffin to be a friend and mentor. Charnell wrote, "Ms. Griffin is the excellent example of commitment to education in Guilford County Schools. She is a team player, a great mentor, and reflects for new teachers a wisdom that is missing from a lack of veteran teachers remaining in the profession. She is very much deserving of this recognition as she has taught countless numbers of students and continues teaching and giving back to the community. She uses the Spanish language to not only teach children, but support Spanish-speaking families and non-Spanish speakers in Guilford County. She works closely with youth as a mentor and delivers food to the needy, families. This truly reflects the mission of Guilford County Schools. Virginia received a $50 gift card from Sam's Club, which has given more than $8,000 to outstanding Guilford County School employees since 2005. Sam's Club has been a supportive partner in recognizing our dedicated employees, and we're so grateful for their ongoing recognition of Guilford County Schools. During the month of March, your photo will hang at the district's central office, at Dudley High, and at the Sam's Club on Wendover Avenue. Stories about our employees of the month, as well as our volunteers of the month, air on Guilford County Schools TV, which can be found on Spectrum Cable, channel 74.1, on AT&T UVerse, channel 99, and on YouTube. At this time, I'd like to ask School Board Member Kim Irby to step down to the podium to present certificates to Ms. Virginia Griffin. Oh, thank you, Mr. Gladden. And as the parent of a Dudley alum, I'd like to personally thank you for everything that you've done at Dudley High School.
So on behalf of the Guilford County Board of Education, we'd like to present you with the certificate of the Employee of the Month. Also, you've already confirmed you received your Sam's Club gift card. Amen. Go ahead and use that quickly, I'm playing. All right, thank you so much for all that you do for Guilford County Schools and Dudley Panthers, and may there always be.
Dudley High School. Thank you very much for considering me as the Employee of the Month. I feel that I was only fulfilling a mission, and it's my assignment, my lifelong assignment, to continue to teach our children and to continue to guide our children. And hopefully there will be more teachers, more retired teachers, who will come back and be willing to give of their talent and their wisdom to continue the Guilford County schools to be the best in the world. Thank you.
Well, you are wearing 50 years of education very well. Oh my goodness. Well, we would like to invite you and any of your family members, any Dudley High alumni, staff, Dudley family here to come up so we can personally congratulate you. Thank you. We are now at the public comments portion of our meeting. We would like to remind our speakers tonight, one, thank you so much for taking time out of your schedules to come and share your comments and concerns with us. When your name is called, we'd like for you to come to the podium, give your name and your address. You have 3 minutes to make your comments. You will get an amber light, 15-second warning when your comments should be wrapping up, and then the red light and a little beeping sound lets you know that your 3 minutes, you've reached your 3 minutes. And so we'd like for everyone to kind of adhere to that so that each speaker can get the time allotted. First person on our agenda tonight is Donovan Hoskins. Would you please come to the podium, followed by Cynthia Miller? Good evening.
Good evening.
Principal Hoskins, how are you?
I'm great. I hope you are.
I'm fine. Thank you.
My name is Donovan Hoskins. I'm the principal at Ben L. Smith, home of the Golden Eagles. Our address is 24/7 South Holden Road, Greensboro. And I'm here tonight on behalf of the students, the staff, and the broader community that we serve, simply to say thank you. Thank you to the Board of Education for supporting the addition of a signature academy at Smith High School. I'd like to thank the superintendent, Dr. Contreras, for believing that now is the right time and Smith is the right place for one of the initial signature academies. I also believe that this advanced manufacturing integrated production technology signature academy, and I say that three times really fast, this advanced manufacturing integrated production technology signature academy has the potential to truly change the trajectory of our students' lives. So thank you again. I'd like to thank the GCS team for all the work that's been put in supporting me and the teachers and the training that will be coming to make sure that the implementation of this academy is a success. I'd like to thank in advance the board and the district for the capital investments and the modifications that will happen to our facilities to also help ensure the successful implementation of this signature academy. And it will be greatly appreciated, I can assure you that. And finally, I'd like to thank you again for this opportunity to stand before you tonight and say thank you. We look forward to the next steps.
Thank you, Mr. Hoskins, and thank you for your leadership
yes,
at
ma'am.
Ben L. Smith High
thank
School.
You.
Cynthia Miller, followed by Shantisha Laughlin.
Good evening. I am Cynthia Miller, the Career Development Coordinator at Ben L. Smith High School. Ben L. Smith High School's address is 247 South Holden Road, Greensboro, North Carolina. As my principal, Mr. Hoskins, has said, I also would like to thank you. I would like to thank you on behalf of the almost 1,300 students at Ben L. Smith High School. Ben L. Smith High School is a high school that all of the students receive free lunches. With this signature academy, in North Carolina, salaries range from $36,000 to $73,000 in advanced manufacturing. We will be able to break the cycle. For that, we say thank you.
Thank you. Shantisha Laughlin, followed by Bridget Wiley.
Hello, Shantisha Laughlin, and the address for Smith is 2407 South Holden Road. According to the CTE program mission, it states that it will empower our students to be successful citizens, workers, and leaders in a global economy. In Guilford County Schools, students are prepared for success by assisting them in the acquisition of soft skills and technical skills. As a CTE educator at Smith High School, the mission for a major overhaul led by Dr. Contreras involving career and technical education and the goal aimed at preparing students for high-wage, high-skill fields is impressive. I have an 11-year-old son that will be entering to middle school. I see the vision that Dr. Contreras has in regards to leveling the playing field by offering opportunities for young black and brown students to be successful, as well as to provide equitable access to CTE courses. This renovation will allow students to be debt-free, leave with a trade or two-year degree. This is beneficial for students who are discovering themselves and shaping the beginning of their future. To me, that means that Dr. Contreras is assisting in producing well-rounded, productive citizens who will be encouraged to reach their maximal potential. With the prediction that the academies will be favorable, provides insight into students having a diverse exposure to educational opportunities. For national CTE statistics, it is proven that 82% of all public high schools offer CTE courses, and 85% of students earn at least one credit in CTE. However, the statistics noted that research is lacking on specific subpopulations as students from various demographic backgrounds. The five-year plan aims to prioritize CTE course offering by reducing hundreds of course options while going more in depth in key fields. By offering courses at Smith, it will assist in positive statistics for our black and brown youth. Imagine the potential and doors that would be open. Aaron Gruwell was quoted, I realize if you can change a classroom, you can change a community. And if you can change enough communities, you can change the world. As a proud GCS employee, I'm in full support of Dr. Contreras and her vision for GCS. Thank you.
Bridget Wiley, followed by Valerie Cromarty.
Good evening.
Good evening.
As they said before, I'm Bridget Wiley, and I'm a social studies teacher at Smith High School, which is 2704 South Holden Road. I recently attended a school faculty meeting and a superintendent's advisory board meeting where I learned that Smith High School would be getting an advanced manufacturing and engineering program. I got so excited. As a high school teacher, we know that not all of our students are going to a four-year college after graduation or pursue a two-year technical degree. Many of our students come from poverty and must go to work immediately after finishing high school, not only to help themselves, but to help their families. Many jobs are available after high school only pay $10 an hour, thereby continuing the cycle of poverty. This program will help students graduated from the program make a living wage. They will graduate with a skill that they can market and build on to earn a decent living. They will go on to be successful workers and leaders in a global economy. Research shows that students participating in CTE classes are more engaged and have better attendance. The future of work, according to a survey done by Duke University, says that the new people coming into the labor market will have to solve complex problems, think critically, be creative, and be able to judge and make decisions clearly. Thanks to this program, our graduates will be ready and will meet the challenge. When the Department of Education passed the Vocational Education Act in 1917, they recognized then what we know now, that preparing students for the workplace while in high school is important and necessary. Thank you, Dr. Contreras and school board members, for seeing the need and implementing a much needed program.
Thank you. And our final speaker is Valerie Cromartie. Good evening.
Good evening. Hi, my name is Valerie Cromartie, Benel Smith High School, 2704 South Holden Road. And I'd like to speak from a parent's perspective. I have two children currently attending Benel Smith High School. One is a sophomore and the other a junior, and each with varied interests, both with goals beyond high school. One has made a commitment to college and the other is undecided. And because of that, there have been conversations in our home about preparation and how important it is in making those goals become a reality, because it's not likely to just happen without preparation. And that's what I believe the Advanced Manufacturing and Engineering program does. It helps prepare students to explore options outside of the 2 or 4 year college track. The Advanced Manufacturing and Engineering program introduces skills training that assists in making the transition from high school to adulthood seem less taxing. Offering students a more secure footing is something they can see, and it gives them hope, and that benefits us all. So I'd like to say thank you to Dr. Contreras and the school board members for embracing the vision and helping to make it a reality. Thank you.
Thank you. That concludes our public comments section of the meeting. We are now at approval of the agenda. We have a motion to accept the agenda. Is there a second?
Second.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? All right, we are now at the consent agenda. Dr. Contreras, I'll turn it over to you to walk us through. I know that our minutes are in there. I hope our board members have had an opportunity to read the minutes from February 12th and February 28th.
Madam Chair, members of the board, this evening the consent agenda includes several items. Those items are the approval of the February 2019 meeting minutes, the personnel report, and the capital fund transfer to career and technical education project ordinance. That concludes this evening's consent agenda for your consideration.
There's a move, is there a second?
Well, I moved it first, but that's fine.
Okay, so we have a move and a second.
Madam Chair.
Yes, ma'am.
May we pull the capital transfer fund for a few minutes of discussion?
Yes, we will move that and put that under the superintendent's report. Is that okay?
Okay.
All those in favor of approving the motion with the removal of the capital fund transfer?
She removed, point of clarification, it's removed for discussion, not removed from the agenda, is that correct?
That's yes. Correct.
Okay, so we're voting on ABC?
Yes.
Okay.
No, you're voting on AB right now.
Well, then that was...
I'm sorry.
You're voting on A and B. C has been pulled.
And we'll have some discussion about it, and then we can vote on C. So all those in favor?
Agenda, not the agenda. It was moved from the consent agenda, not the agenda of the whole meeting.
So all those in favor, well, I guess we can just go ahead and vote on that. Great, thank you. So we'll move that under the superintendent's report. We are now at the chair's report. I have a few things to report. Good evening. The Guilford County Board of Education and the Guilford County Board of Commissioners will hold a joint meeting on Thursday to discuss the final results of a district-wide facilities and boundary optimization study. This examines long and short-term facility needs for Guilford County Schools. The meeting will begin at 5:30 at McNair Elementary. Guilford County Schools has partnered with North Carolina Works, NC Works, to offer school-to-work hiring event this Saturday from 9 to 11 a.m. And the NC Works Career Center, 2301 West Meadowview Road, Greensboro. Students and graduates ages 16 to 24 are invited to come prepared to be interviewed for permanent higher jobs with benefits, as well as summer jobs. The event will also occur on April 6th at NC Works on Idle Street in High Point. Fairview is celebrating more than 100 years of history. Fairview alumni, community members, and special guests will gather on Saturday at 10:30 a.m. to explore the transformation that Fairview Elementary has undergone in the last century. We are proud of our schools, and we love to see efforts to preserve and celebrate their history. Thank you to the students at the Middle College at North Carolina A&T State University who collected gym equipment and other materials for Bessemer Elementary, which lost many of its resources in a fire earlier this year. During the month of February, the high school students worked to collect PE supplies to donate and support the students and staff at Bessemer Elementary. This is the latest example of an ongoing partnership between the two schools. Congratulations to Allen Middle School Ethan Quick and Northwest High student Imali Anderson. Their artwork was selected to adorn the 2019 Board of County Commissioners budget document. The student and art teachers will be honored for their fine work at the March 21st, 2009 Board of County Commissioners meeting at 5:30, located at 301 West Market Street in Greensboro. Thank you to Allen Middle art teacher Maria Miller and Northwest High art teacher Beth Herrick for their amazing work with our students. And finally, I would like to congratulate the High Point Central High Black History Quiz Bowl team, who took first place in the 9th annual event. Participating students were Jasmine Thomas, Christopher Harper, Starlin Mendez, and Thaddeus Jackson. And the team answered every answer correctly. This is their second year in a row as first place winners, and the students will go on to compete at the state level. This concludes my remarks. Dr. Contreras.
Thank you. Good evening again. The 2019 GCS Choice Showcase will be held tomorrow, March 13th, from 5:30 to 8:30 p.m. at the Greensboro Coliseum Special Events Center. The event and parking are free. Rising ninth graders will be the first to apply for 6 new signature academies that emphasize career and technical education opportunities that are in high demand in our region, state, and nation. The district's JROTC programs will be included in this year's showcase. GCS offers more than 50 magnet and choice programs from pre-kindergarten to high school. The Youth Art Month Elementary Art Gallery is now on display at the Greensboro Cultural Center, located at 200 North Davie Street in Greensboro. We invite everyone out to the reception to honor students and teachers on Sunday, March 17th, from 1 to 3 p.m. The gallery and reception are also free and open to the public. The All-County Elementary School Chorus Concert will be Tuesday, March 19th at 7 p.m. at Smith High in the auditorium. The concert features a 250-voice mass choir, comprised of fifth grade students from every elementary school in GCS. The event is free and open to the public. GCS Arts will be sending 12,000 third and fourth grade students to experience the symphony on March 21st through 27th in the Grimsley High Auditorium at 9:30 and 11:15 daily. Thank you to the Greensboro Symphony for their longtime partnership, providing this excellent opportunity for students. During the past 40 years, GCS has ensured that more than 1 million students have experienced the Greensboro Symphony concerts. Battle of the Books was held March 4th through 6th, and we are proud of all 94 teams that battled. Two of those schools, Northern Elementary and Northwest Middle, qualified for the regional competition later this spring. At the elementary level, winners were first place Northern Elementary, second place Brooks Global, third place Lindley Elementary. At the middle school level, winners were first place Northwest Middle, second place Brown Summit Middle, and third place Kaiser Middle. And at the high school, winners were first place Grimsley High, second place Page High, and third place, Northern High. Congratulations to these schools and to all the teams that participated. I'd like to take a moment this evening to express my thanks to the 4 Guilford County representatives and the entire GCS state delegation who put forth a bill that would help us expand our career and technical education programming. John Hardister, Amos Quick, John Faircloth, and Ashton Clemens filed House Bill 275, CTE pilot for Guilford County Schools. a bill that would allocate $3 million to Guilford County Schools to implement a career and technical pilot program. The pilot program would be evaluated and considered for permanency after a six-year period. Guilford County Schools placed this item on its 2019 legislative agenda and requested funds from the General Assembly. The Greensboro Chamber of Commerce also supports the program and placed it on its 2019 legislative agenda. We are grateful to see the support of our legislators on this key issue. As I conclude my remarks, I'd like to share that this has been a particularly difficult week and a half for the GCS family. I'd like to express sincere condolences to the family of Joshua Perry, an eighth grade student at Southeast Middle School who passed away this past weekend. Dr. LeGrand, Dr. Carr, and Dr. Morrison are visiting with the family at Joshua's home right now. I'd also like to send my deepest condolences to the family of Sincere Davis, a 12th grader at Page High School who passed away earlier this afternoon. Our thoughts are with the entire Southeast Middle School and Page High School communities. GCS is also extending well wishes to Christian Martin, student athlete at Southwest High School, who was injured during Saturday evening's basketball game. We are anticipating your speedy recovery. This concludes my remarks.
Thank you, Superintendent. And I also placed under your report the capital fund transfer to career and technical education. Anita?
Yes, just a few comments that I wanted to make before we vote. This is to transfer $7.1 million out of project ordinances into a new project ordinance that will support the CTE academies. A large portion of that money is coming out of funds that will remain from High Point Central project when that is complete. And I want the High Point Central people to understand that they began in 2008 with that bond only having $1.3 million to work with. Since that time, we have transferred over to High Point Central $20.6 million. And that's from projects that were complete and had funds remaining, red light camera money, insurance proceeds. There were like eight sources of that money. From that, we've been able to complete a new cafeteria, renovations to their historic auditorium, a new media center, ProStart classroom. And if you don't know what ProStart is, that is food preparation. It's a great facility, great renovation. We're still completing, have not 100% completed, the renovation of six gang bathrooms, and we're also working on the sprinkler system. We believe that we will have sufficient money left in the budget to complete all the work that we are committed to at Central and still have funds to move to work on the CTE programs. The main portion of the money came from the sprinkler system that we estimated and budgeted $8.7 million, but believe we can finish that with a cost of 3.1. And we're not taking all the money at this point in time so that if they run into any obstacles in finishing the work, there's sufficient money there to do it. And I just felt it was very critical that my High Point Central family understand that they're not getting shortchanged on any of the work, and they have, in fact, been a beneficiary of other projects that have come in.
Thank you, Anita. Any other questions? All right, is there a second?
Substitute motion.
Mm-hmm.
What is a substitute motion?
You want to hear it?
Yes.
Okay, that we approve the transfer of $7,113,803 from various capital project ordinances specified in the memorandum from staff into a CTE capital improvement project ordinance, and further that we forward to the Guilford County Board of County Commissioners a request to approve the CTE capital improvement project ordinance and transfer the funds as described.
What's different from this motion?
I believe that's the motion that
Yes.
Okay, excellent. Do we have a second on that?
Second.
All right, all those in favor of the substitute motion, please use your tab.
The motion contains all the elements that you need to have to move this forward.
So Anita gets it this time.
Okay.
All right.
Let's vote.
That's a proper motion.
The motion passes unanimously.
Great, thank you. We are now at board member comments. We'll start with Mr. Tillman. Can you go first? Oh, that's right, you have somewhere to go. Pat, would you mind if Winston goes first, and then we'll go that way, you can go third.
Just a point of personal privilege. I'm headed to my son's band concert at Grimsley High School. Dr. Stefan Stuber, who has been a longtime and beloved band director there for, I think, decades, is retiring this year. So a particularly important spring event, and I want to make it to the concert. So thank you. Just a few quick words of thanks. I'm excited about how we continue to move forward with the CTE program in the midst of the complexities and the discussion, and really looking forward to that. Appreciate the Smith High community being here today to talk about the excitement and the conversations you're having at the staff level. So thank you. I had a great opportunity to start my day at Fraser Elementary School today. I had not been there before, but there was a community reader day done with the Newcomers Club, and enjoyed meeting Principal Avery, a longtime principal there, 8 years. That continuity, I think, is serving that community well. I read to a group of third graders the book that the superintendent gave us recently about how Georgia Gilmore sustained the Montgomery boycott. They had lots of questions and lots of great discussion around that. And at some point in our discussion, I told them that my sons were at Grimsley, and they were super excited to tell me they were going to Grimsley to hear the symphony in a couple of weeks. Like, they knew this was happening in their lives, and they were pretty excited just about the music opportunity. So I always think it's fun to see the various pieces come together sort of out in classrooms with students. But I will say the conversation was very rich this morning around the book. So thank you for the book, the opportunity to read it. Ms. Scott, that teacher, had clearly been doing some great discussions with them through the month of February, and I really enjoyed that. I also had a chance to visit Hunter recently and for another community reader day, and also saw there the great work of a longtime principal, and just appreciate that staff team too. So thank you to my board member colleagues. I'm going to sneak out and actually catch the beginning of the concert. Thank you.
And Linda and Pat, if you will please bear with me. Byron also is trying to get to a meeting with some business leaders in our community. Would you mind if Byron goes, and I'll come back this way.
Thank you so much, Madam Chair. I'm headed to the Greensboro Business League roundtable with the County Commissioner, City Council, and Board of Education. So I'll be brief. It's been, as you stated earlier, a very difficult week. I want to uplift Carolyn Tigers was the mother who was gunned down on Eugene, and two of her children are school age and in Gifford County Schools, and so the memorial was had, or will be had, I believe, on this week. Uplift that as well. It's very unfortunate when senseless violence attacks our community. Thank you all for the well wishes and my maxi B cake, because I'll be another year older on Friday. So it is the Pisces month. We are the best, hands down. And everyone have safe and happy travels, and I have to get to that lunch meeting. Also, the hub committee meeting, it is a public meeting, will be February 26th at 2:30 here.
Maybe March.
I'm sorry. Thank you. March 26th. I'm stuck on February. March 26th at 2:30 here in the boardroom. So if you all have the time and availability, please come out to learn about what we've done and where we're going. Thank you all, and have a safe travel.
Thank you. Thank you. Linda, we'll get back in order here.
I want to just say I did get the opportunity to go out to Nathaniel Green for Read Across America. It was exciting. It's amazing how smart these kids are. And so I truly enjoyed that. And the other thing is I have to give a big shout out to the Southeast Falcon Ladies, who are going to the North Carolina Association of Athletic, the NCAA, however that is, class 3A. You can tell I'm a real sports person. And they are really excited about their championship, and it'll be Saturday, March 16th, which I'm afraid I won't be able to go to, but I would be there if I could. But we want to give them all the support we can. We're very excited for them. So go Falcons. Yes.
Thank you, Linda Pat.
Yes. Well, I just got here, so now I'll just, you know, summarize the last couple weeks. I had the opportunity, it was a great privilege to observe the Guilford delegation town hall that was this past week. And so many of you remember our legislative breakfast that we had at Alan J. Prep. And so this was in some ways a sort of continuation of that, but this was an opportunity for the citizens to address some of those priorities that we all share and some other ones that maybe we don't have as much information about, but that are very important to our citizens. And what I'll just give you a quick snapshot of that. The takeaway is that we really have a very much bipartisan group of legislators, and particularly in Guilford, and they all commented, Republican and Democrat alike, that they haven't really seen this kind of spirit in a long time. And some of those legislators have, like Senator Robinson and others, have been in Raleigh a very long time and have seen lots of governors come and go and legislatures come and go. So we ought to feel really encouraged about that, particularly to those issues that are important to the school board and to our community with respect to those issues, as they are working very hard together. And to that end, there's been a lot of talk. I wanted to kind of hopefully maybe at least provide some clarity to the issues about the bond, the state bond, in terms of those construction dollars. There was an article in the paper that Guilford was going to get $12 million, and rightfully so. People were animated about that and very upset, as I said, justifiably so. But there's also other legislation that's being crafted that has a different formula that actually 2 years ago, a senator that chaired the Education Committee had drafted, and the dollars were very much different. So there's going to be a move, and I'm not speaking out of school here, to get that formula back on the table, because the formula we have now is not, I think we would all agree, not equitable and not fair. If you look at the size of our district, any criteria that you can use, tier one, tier two, doesn't matter. Anybody that saw those numbers would have big time questions, and we do. So that's being worked on, and not to steal any thunder from the chair, but just wanted to share that, because I know sometimes you read things in the paper and it there's no context. So I just wanted to share that on behalf of the board. And I really want to lift up, I'll close with, that we are with in thought and prayer with the Davis family, Page, the Page family. What a tragedy. And I just hope that somehow we can find a way to come together and heal and grow from that tragic event. So thank you for my time.
Thank you, Pat. Diane?
First, I want to thank the High Point Ministerial Alliance for asking the sheriff, Danny Rogers, the DA, Ms. Crump, the chief of police from High Point, and on yesterday in trying to figure out what can we do about some of the violence. And they specifically asked what could they do as far as our schools are concerned. And of course, I encourage them to encourage their church members to be present and at our schools, to volunteer, to talk in their community about conflict resolution as opposed to using violence to fight. But they very much want to know what can they do to help with deterring the violence in High Point. I want to invite everybody to the Fairview celebration on Saturday. Starts at 10 o'clock. This will be recognizing that Fairview has, as a school, has been there for 102 years. Also, ACC Women's Tournament was here, and I want to thank the number of our ROTCs that were there to bring out the flag, to present the colors, because I think sometimes we don't realize how engaged our children and our schools are in community functions. And there were a number of our schools that were represented there. And, you know, as a grandmother, I kind of watched to see how kids behave. And I can tell you that our kids represented us very well as far as, you know, doing what they were supposed to do, you know, which is important, because people don't want to invite folks to come to your house if you don't know how to behave. So we want to thank the principals and other folks who made sure that our children enjoyed themselves. I hate Carolina didn't make it, but next year. We want to remember the families and staff of students and staff this week who have either had challenges or lost someone, because it does affect us, and all we can do is pray and hope that their healing will be something that we can help them with. And then finally, the CTE buzz. Everywhere I go, people are asking me questions about the CTE program. They're very excited in the community about what we are proposing to do. So kudos to our superintendent and to the staff for moving forward and trying to make sure that this program hits the mark, and it's only the beginning. And I hope that we will continue to get the support from business community. Parents are asking, and I do hope that people do come out tomorrow to the showcase so that they can, you know, have their questions answered. And Madam Superintendent, I think I've been asked to represent you on Bottom Line next Tuesday. And so even though we're supposed to be talking about the facility study, I'll also try to, you know, lift up the CTE program again and get people to call in and ask questions about what they can do to get their children involved in this effort. Thank you.
Anita?
Not much to say except that my heart is with the families of Page and Southeast Middle School, and specifically Sincere Davis family and Joshua Perry family. There's no worse loss than the loss of a child, and we have lost two this week. So lift these families up, and let's keep them in our hearts and our prayers.
Thank you. Kim?
Thank you. I also would like to extend condolences to those families, and we are going to keep them in our prayers. In honor of Women's History Month, I would like to recognize and give a few facts about Katherine Johnson, who was a mathematician, and she graduated from college at the age of 18, double majoring in mathematics and French. She worked on the calculation to help get the Apollo astronauts home from the moon. In 2015, then President Barack Obama honored Katherine with the Presidential Medal of Freedom, which is the highest honor of United States civilians. In 2016, the story of Katherine, Dorothy Vaughan, and Mary Jackson was told in box office smash Hidden Figures. I want to encourage our girls to definitely apply to the CTE program. We want to make sure that the girls are accessing these programs as well. So I want to encourage them, because we have a living example in Katherine Johnson. I also would like to share that I had an opportunity to visit Kearns Academy to see what it is that we're going to be doing, what the rooms are going to look like, and try to get a vision for that. And I have to say that all the staff, they're excited about what's coming to Kearns Academy. I'm excited about what's going to happen there as well. And I'm just asking that we make sure that whatever we're doing, that we be inclusive of the principals and the teachers, so that we can definitely design and retrofit the rooms the way that they need to be done, so that way we can be smart about the improvements that we're going to make in the CTE program. Thank you again.
Thank you, and I'd like to join my colleagues in extending heartfelt condolences to the families who have lost our young students and to their school communities, and hope that healing comes soon. I'd like to thank the board members who were able to attend our retreat this Saturday, where we are all committed to board development, to working more effectively and efficiently together. I had an opportunity to spend the last 2 days in one of our sister cities with philanthropic leaders, school board members, representatives from nonprofit organizations that are very committed to issues of equity. And so we're not alone in that across the state. And I was at the Chamber of Commerce meeting in Greensboro early this morning where enjoyed a presentation around entrepreneurial projects, and the superintendent did not waste that opportunity and did talk about our CTE programs. So know where the buzz is coming from, Diane. And that concludes my comments. So is there a motion to adjourn?
I just wanted to say we were going into closed session, but I would like to ask, as two board members had to leave to one for personal reason, Mrs. Garrett cannot be here, and one is representing us at another meeting. If we could defer this item to another meeting, we also have a meeting later this week, and board members Wellborn, Gladden, and Irby and I will also be visiting our federal delegation this weekend to advocate for the Rebuilding America Schools Act 2019, and also to increase the entitlement funds, Title I, III, and V, and also to ensure Title II, which is recommended to be cut once again. It's recommended for elimination, is not eliminated. It is our only source for professional development for teachers in our district. We'll be advocating for that on Monday with the federal delegation. With that, I would ask that we postpone the closed session.
Thank you. I'm sorry, I didn't see that on the agenda. Is that all those in favor of removing that and putting that on another agenda?
Unless there's a reason for not delaying it. Mm-hmm.
Well, it's not time sensitive. I'm good with it. Right. Do we need a motion for that, or is
it? No, you can just adjourn.
Motion to adjourn.
Second. We have a motion to adjourn.
Second.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Anybody want to stay?
Thank you. Aye.